Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today I've got a game for you with Valkyrie and his Halland, the tier 10 pan-European destroyer. And he's playing on Northern Lights in a domination game. And he's attacking Charlie Cap. So we'll see if he can take this cap circle. Be nice if you could get some early points on the board. It's a DD, you always want to try and do this if you can. Not always possible, it depends on the makeup of the enemy team, and it also depends on whether how many radars there are on the enemy team generally, you know. So he's going to get some early torpedoes out on the gross care first here, which is definitely the correct thing to do. And we see the enemy Kleber coming in at full speed. And I would imagine that that Kleber has probably sent some torpedoes of his own. So, Valkyrie wisely moves away from the cap. Absolutely the right thing to do at this point. You don't want to get spotted early game if you can avoid it. Especially in a DD, as you know. And the Halland's only got 22,700 hit points to play with. I know it's got a heal, but still, it's not the tankiest of DDs. Let's put it that way. Some nice hits there on the Kerr first. Yep, four torps there, lovely. And a couple of floodings as well, right? But he damage conned that pretty much instantly, I think. So Kleber's just going to hang around. And this guy is no idiot. I mean, he sent those torpedoes and they reached the edge of the cap circle where Valkyrie just was. So he knows exactly what he's doing, this guy. And I would suggest that he's going to reverse back into that cap circle from the south. So Valkyrie needs to be careful, but obviously he outspots him. But unfortunately, I don't think there's a single ship on Valkyrie's team here that can shoot that Kleber. So I think Valkyrie's going to take matters into his own hands here and send a couple of salvos of torpedoes. Yeah, just a quick note on that send. I think I would have probably sent both sets straight at this guy. Just to absolutely make sure that he couldn't avoid at least one, you know. Oh, yes, and he wasn't quick enough. Which is not really surprising when the Halland torps do 90 knots. So yeah, Kleber paid a little bit there for his indiscretion, thankfully. I mean, it's such a shame that there's nobody else can actually shoot this guy, and it must have been incredibly frustrating for Valkyrie at this point not to be able to get into that cap circle. So it's kind of a stalemate here on sea. Looking around the map, the enemy are pushing heavily into Alpha Cap, and there's only three ships there to defend, and we've got the usual sort of standoff situation in the Delta Cap as well. In my opinion, Pete, the guys in Delta need to be a little bit more aggressive and push forward. Which, you know, they might do. We'll see. It's early doors. So a second set of fast torpedoes away there on the Kleber. And Valkyrie gives him the good news of the guns. Distracts his attention a little bit. Yeah, and he's going to catch that one. Lovely. The more I look at the minimap, the more I'm becoming concerned about the friendly daring in the 10 line. not an optimal position for that destroyer. It should be in, should be supporting Valkyrie in the middle at this point. Kremlin also well out of position, and a Henry IV doing nothing. So the three ships on the friendly team, they're pretty much useless at this point in the game. And the friendly team have lost four ships already. This is going to be a hell of an uphill struggle for Valkyrie here. And he finds himself pretty much isolated on Charlie Cap. I might have gone back into that cap, however, because the Kleber had to leave after taking all that damage from Valkyrie. He's got some torpedoes away on the Preussen. And we'll see where this gets him, but he needs to be careful. There's a Nevsky charging in, and a Mosfa that's only 13.3 kilometres away at this point. Very dangerous to charge into this lot. I think I might have erred on the side of caution and turned round at this point. But I think it's a little bit too late. the Kleber needs to take some damage here. But Valkyrie does get some torps into the battleship, and he takes out the Preussen, which is great, you know. And the Kleber's a little bit... he's low. Good. So, and he takes out the Kleber for a lovely double strike there. But he has... he's paid a little bit, but probably not as much as I would have thought. I mean, there's four enemy ships there shooting at him, because we've got pretty much nothing else to shoot at, and I was quite surprised that he didn't take a little bit more damage. And of course there's the radar, as expected, either Nevsky or the Moskva there activating the radar. But you know, Valkyrie's brave, he's gonna shoot on the Yamato. And I think I'd probably do the same thing at this point, nothing to lose. Friendly team are down six ships, but Valkyrie's valiant effort here is redressing the balance, I think. I would suggest, however, that not taking the Charlie Cap earlier when he could have might be the difference between winning or losing this game. But please don't misunderstand what I'm saying here. Valkyrie's done a fantastic job defending against this pushing, hard pushing enemy team here. And he's got some more torpedoes out on the Mosfa here. And they're looking pretty good. Yep, the Swedish Ticklers hit home for, what was that, 21,000 damage for four torp hits. And that's another radar. Yeah, nice bit of dodging here. Some nice throttle jockeying. And I suspect that the enemy team are becoming overconfident, should I say. A couple of nice sets of predicted torps there, predicting the Mosfa's right-hand turn. And he's obviously going to turn back towards the Charlie Cap, I think. And his guns aren't pointed in Valkyrie's direction, so why not open up? Again, absolutely the right thing to do at this point. Nice shooting here, very good. and a couple of torp strikes, and the Mosfa goes down. Very nicely done, Valkyrie. So I think we need to reassess the situation, and we can see the Henry IV in the south of Delta Cap, the Petro and the Daring together, the two Hallands here in the north. And you know, if the Petro does push into the Bravo Cap, that's a good move, no problem with that. But I'm really disappointed with the way the Daring's played this game, to be honest. Not quite sure why he hasn't been pushing into the Charlie Cap. And the Henry IV's pretty much been left to his own devices on Charlie. And Valkyrie's got another couple of sets of torpedoes away against the Nevsky there. And the Nevsky is clearly the big threat to Valkyrie and his teammate in the other Halland to the north. Yeah, he gets a strike on the Nevsky, which is good. Fast moving, difficult to hit target there. The Halland torps, if you're going to hit with torpedoes, you're going to hit with the Halland. Okay, so Valkyrie decides to slow down and send some torps on the Slaver. Again, taking targets of opportunity in defence. Absolutely crucial as a DD player. And there's the radar from the Nevsky. A very frightening prospect. You don't want to get shot by that thing at 10 kilometres. A good Nevsky player will take... Hey, but the Nevsky's just taken a huge amount of damage from the Halland in the north. Well played to him. So, opening up with the guns. And I think between them, they should be able to deal with this Nevsky now. He's on pretty low health. Shots just falling behind there from Valkyrie. Bit of a shame really, because I believe that could have been a really nice Kraken at this point. But of course the enemy Ragnar turns up, opening up with his 150mm guns, a very scary prospect for any DD. Whether it be tier 8, tier 9 or tier 10, you don't want to get shot by the Ragnar. It's got an incredible rate of fire and does a lot of damage, and it's also got a decent radar as well, so Valkyrie needs to keep his distance here and send some torpedoes into the cap and try and put this guy off a little bit, but he needs to stay at distance. And the friendly team actually go into the lead here. It's very close, but the friendly team do have the points advantage. So surely this could be a win, right? You've not played World of Warships before, have you? Oh dear. So the Ragnar's in the Delta Cap. And if all things stay the same, he'll definitely take it. Unless Valkyrie and his friend in the Halland to the north can do something about this guy. So some more speculative torpedoes into the Delta Cap. And Valkyrie's trying to bait the Ragnar into shooting at him so he can see him at least, but he's not doing that, so quite surprised at this point. Also very surprised about the friendly Daring chasing an enemy Kilbear. Oh, and Valkyrie gets his high calibre and Confederate there, which is absolutely fantastic and well deserved, I must say. But getting back to the daring, what the hell is that guy doing? The friendly daring has chased a Colbert of all ships that can absolutely take him apart in a matter of seconds instead of taking the caps. I think his gameplay is very questionable. And the Ragnar characters are shooting the Henri there. More importantly, the friendly daring is taking the Colbert under fire in the north. He's not going to last and he will die. So, you know, that's a trade, I guess. And Valkyrie now has to travel into the Delta Cap to try and recover some points. I can't believe what that daring did, to be honest. It really hasn't been helpful to the team. He should have been taking the caps minutes ago. Unfortunately, he can't legislate for bad play, and usually comes down to a minority of the team to carry the game. And as we see here, the enemy have gone into the lead, and if Valkyrie's team lose this, it's an absolute heartbreaker, isn't it? I mean, who's trying to who's trying to throw this game harder? I can't quite fathom it at the moment. It's unfathomable, it really is. Valkyrie, sorry for your loss, mate. I mean, there was clearly no winning this game, whatever you did. You played a fantastic match. Maybe if people actually understood how to play this game, we might get better games in the future. Alright guys, thanks for watching as always, and take care.